everybody, and welcome back to the final part of Let's Play Shantae and the Pirate's Curse. We have done Scuttletown, Saliva Island, Spiderweb Island, Tanline Island, Mudbog Island, Frostbite Island, and now we are going to the Lonely Grave. And I'm going to say, like, again, the audio didn't record for this, I don't know why. It is in post, it's going to be post-commentary. However, if you cannot hear, the blue snowball is working, so my voice should sound a lot clearer, because I have now got the blue microphone, the new one that is. I did need a replacement, and the blue company, very helpful, very lovely, they give me the replacement, and that's now on the ringer. So I've now got the blue snowball with the ringer on it, with a pop filter now in front of the snowball, and a static cancellor in the back so that the static is reduced, and I'm going to take a drink because I know what's coming and the Pirate Master is going to kill my voice across this next 45 minutes. So let's take a drink and get ready. Lovely. Can he really hear us? Yes, he can. He knows we're here and he knows I'm talking about him for all of YouTube, so shall we go meet him? Should anything go wrong, I want you to gather up all of the dark magic. Wow, I was slow pressing the A button. Or I must have been making a comment about the dark magic. And destroy it!
But Risky, didn't you say...
That's an order!
I got it.
Okay then. I'll prepare some powder kegs for the Pirate Master's final farewell. Don't wander off. Although this island is literally only two screens long and the final dungeon takes place somewhere else. But shall we go meet him? And then I'm going to talk about how pissed I am at EA. Because it's always fun to bash EA. Without the dark magic to draw from, he's vanished into the eternal abyss. Too bad, really. After all, what good is a victory if you can't rub it in your enemy's face?
What was that?
He is not quite dead yet. Ho 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 ho! So you've managed to return after all! Ha 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 ha! I'm not going to do the laugh, not in the deep voice that we're gonna have for him. Cause he's gonna talk like a real pirate! How dare ye betray me! You're nothing but a shade, I'm through taking orders from you. You watched and did nothing as I fell in battle. You stole me ship and me crew. And now you destroyed my agents and disrupted my flow of dark magic.
Actually, I did that.
You will suffer for this.
There's no reason to get all worked up, Captain. See this girl? She's the offspring of the one who imprisoned you. The genies are the real enemy. Take her, and we'll call it even.
Risky! Oh, that can wait. You're the one I want. I will make you pay for your disloyalty.
I've had it with your blasted orders. Your time has passed. Go back to the grave where you belong.
Fool, you belong to me.
Risky.
No, that kiss.
You dare to wear my face like some kind of trophy? Give me that. First, I will take the palace. And then, when my strength has returned, you will witness the end of your world. Oh,
yeah, he just keeps laughing. And he's gone.
Oh no, I've got to warn everyone. But what is it that Risky said before? I should make sure to find all the dark magic first. But what good will that do?
Well, we will certainly maybe find out near the end of the game, but we do not have to worry about collecting all of the dark magic, because as mentioned, all of the dark magic has been collected, every island has been completed, so we are just going to head off to his castle. But it looks like it's just me and the boat now, so let's see if I've really got what it takes to be a pirate. I've asked you at dog's time to swab the plank. And off we go. Moisten the main snails. Kill the port blubber. Aye, aye, Captain.
And as you can see, Scutter Town has got a dark, looming cloud over it. Ooh, spooky.
So, as we said, every island has now got all of its ticks complete, so shall we head off to take him down once and for all in our final battle? I think we should. And as you can see, the music has also changed. It's all dark and dismal. But if you just charge, you can pretty much charge through the entire section right to his palace. No need to worry about anything, although I do screw it up on the next screen. But regardless, I want to give EA some shit, because, you know, it's fun to give EA shit, because EA's been fucking up. Because you see, today is February 9th, and today, a game was going to come out that I was going to review after XCOM 2. I've played XCOM 2 at my friend's house, and I will be buying it probably after this recording, but oh my god, XCOM 2 is so good. But I wanted to get a game today which I was going to review because it's coming out today, and it's like, oh, I can't wait for this game, it looks really charming. And it is Unraveled, which was shown off at last year's E3, and it's the, you know, the little red yarn guy, and I was like, oh, Unraveled, this looks really good, it's kind of like Yoshi's Woolly World, it looks so cute and adorable, and apparently, like, the ending will make you cry. And it's like, yeah, and it's cheap, you know, because it's this guy's first game, and he was like, oh, I'm only going to charge, like, £5-10 for it. I can't believe I'm standing here on stage with all of you. And it's like, oh, the, you know, £5, this should be alright. But anyway, and regardless of the price may have changed by now, because obviously that was at E3, but regardless of the price for a moment, I was like, alright, I'm going to buy this today. Turns out, though, because EA is EA, and EA is an asshole, you're only going to be able to buy it on Origins! So, I hope everybody on Steam, all of you people that were on Steam, I hope that you weren't looking to buy Unravel, because you got to buy it on... Nearly sneezed. There we go. Nope, gotta sneeze again. No, I'm fine. But yeah, so I hope all of you who have a Steam weren't planning on buying it on Steam, because it's not going to be available on Steam. It's going to be Origin only, so I won't be able to review that, nor will I be able to play it, because EA has another thing coming if it thinks that I'm going to download fucking Origin, because Origin is absolutely horrible and garbage. So there's that out of the way, because, you know, EA are EA and EA are assholes. I was really looking forward to that as well. I'm actually quite annoyed. I was looking forward to playing Unraveled, and then it's like, oh, I'm sorry, but Origin only, because fuck you, basically. Because if the game was shit, not that it will be, because I trust that guy as a first-time guy to not fuck it up, but then again, EA have had their grubby little hands over it, so they could have easily destroyed his original vision. But, you know, with the EA now having a thing in it, it's like, well, we put it on Origins, because if it was shit, people would return it and we would lose money. And we don't want people returning our product and losing money. So instead, we are going to put it on Origins, where there is no return policy, so you can't get your money back. Oh, we're not so stupid after all. Now you can't get a refund. So, in short, fuck EA for only putting Unraveled on Origins. But here we are in the second floor. You're watching me get through the first floor, and here we are in the second floor, where we just got to take a shot up and over, and then we're heading up to the third floor. There are five? Is there four or five? I don't remember now. Because there's the runny bit, and then there's the glidey bit, and then you get up, because as you can see, the palace gets more and more mutated as we climb the tower. What's this way? So this weighs the thing, and then we go into the glide. So that's the second. Yeah, so there's only two floors left. There are four floors of the Pirate Master, each floor getting progressively more difficult. So as you can see, we are on the third floor right now. The fourth floor is where you've got to glide on updrafts and downdrafts while avoiding the Mario spikes, which I want to talk about because I need to wonder something, but we'll wonder that when the Mario spikes come back, because they're Super Mario World spikes. They absolutely have to be Super Mario World spikes. But yeah, that's all of the updates, because I know that I always forget this guy's name, and he's a regular viewer, and I feel so bad. But one of my commenters, one of you watching this now, he has the Zangief. I'm gonna have to get his name. Wait there, let me just turn to my laptop and get his name again. Because he has a Zangief, and I always want to call you Zangief, but you're not Zangief because you've got a different name. Previously read, Rasko. His name's Rasko. But yeah, Rasko was saying in one of my previous videos, he'd love for me to comment more on my daily life and doing stuff. And the reason I haven't is because, you know, the Shantae episodes have been slightly short of recent, because the ruined factory was only like 3 rooms long, pretty short, end the episode. Then the collection thing was pretty short, end the episode. And throughout the collection and the final dungeon, which were short end the episodes, in those short episodes, I was saying like, oh, well, I've now bought a blue snowball, I've bought a ringer, I'm waiting for the pop filter, but now the blue snowball's got a crackling. So we've had this whole saga of the microphone and trying to get the microphone working. But as you can probably hear via the snowball, ringer, pop filter, and static reducer, as long as I now know how to set Audacity right, because that's probably... I watched my witness review back on YouTube, because, you know, sometimes in Camtasia with your own speaker, it might be a bit different, but I watched it back in YouTube, and then I watched it a second time at my friend's house, and it does seem that the audio balance is off slightly. But remember with my old headset when I was playing Isaac, and I was kind of like, oh, hold on, and I like did that to set the audio balance. Well, obviously the audio balance was set on that, but this is a brand new microphone now. It's a Blue Snowball, fantastic microphone, and I'm watching Audacity, like, as I'm recording this, like, I'm watching the screen to tell you that we're on the fourth screen, but I've got Audacity playing in the corner, and I keep seeing, like, the volume control jumping up and down, so that might have to be set and balanced out. So, we have got a new microphone, and the saga is now over. As you can probably hear, it works completely fine, and it might even sounded fine for you in the witness, but I will just have to do a little bit of audio balancing. But for the rest of it, though, it's all good. So that's why I didn't talk much about what's been going on in my, you know, daily life, because people are like, hey, I want to get to know you more. I mean, obviously, we're not going to talk about stupid things like, oh yeah, by the way, my bank details are the Bank of Celestia in fucking Canterlot. That's it. No, we're not going to be talking about that kind of daily life. It's just like, what do? Do you draw? I mean, I do draw. I've got DeviantArt. And it's like, what do? Do you draw? Tell us about your daily life, Spyro. So, in the next couple of, you know, across the next couple of series, episodes, I don't know, because this is the last episode, so I guess the next series, Spooky maybe, I will try and communicate with you all more, like, maybe do a Ask Me Anything, and if it's not completely ridiculous, like, where do you live so that I can come to your house and rape you, then, you know, if it's just like, do you like art, do you play guitars and stuff, I'll probably start doing an Ask Me Anything, so you can all ask me questions about things. I don't know what things, whatever you want to ask me. I guess that's why it's called an Ask Me Anything. And obviously, I will pick out the questions that aren't just completely stupid. I mean, you can have completely stupid questions, like, you can have, oh god, now I've got to think of a really stupid question. I mean, you could have, like, stupid questions, like, would you have sex with Princess Luna? Answer yes. That's a silly, outrageous question, but it's like a thing that's like, okay, yeah, it's, sure, it's silly and outrageous, but we'll answer it. Whereas a silly question like, what's your bank details? Yeah, that's That's a silly question that's just like, no, don't be silly. You know, you can be silly in the silly way of asking where the screw horse is, but you can't be silly in the silly way of saying, what's this extremely secure information? That'd just be silly now. But yeah, we are, this is the final room, by the way. Once we clear this room, we head up the tower to the actual Pirate Master himself. I think there's one more room where we've got to glide and use the cannon to get back to the right-hand side, because the tower is always on the right-hand side, so we will clear this room, and then we will do one more room that's above this one to get to the right-hand side again, which has got, like, a load of demons in it, all the little chibi demon things. So, like, we glide, or we gotta, like, cannon glide, and this will be the last room, then we head up to the Pirate Master. So as you can see, there's the cannon, here's the glide, and then we do this. And here comes a lovely heart-shaped thing with a million little chibi demons. I'm sorry, a wall of chibi demons did not hit me. And now we start our final ascent into the Pirate Master. As you can see now, there's like mouths and things in this very twisted, mutilated top of the tower here, because it just gets more messed up the higher up you go. But we have made it, and we got a save, man. So we're going to hit our jars to get our health back, and then we're going to save. Then we're going to go into the final battle. So, save for me, old man. Beautiful. And then we're going to go through the silent corridor. Listen. Silence in that final hallway. You see the witness, silence is used as a transition point. Idiots. I'm not going to go into my whole witness thing. I'm going to say that I did not like the witness that much, like, nearly at all. So, yeah, let's not talk about that. There's 45 minutes of me just voicing my displeasement at some of the things that the witness does, like having no music, considering it's a 200-hour game. For now, let us fight the Pirate Master. And I will say, like, with the Pirate Master, I do get hit on this first phase, because I wasn't paying attention. I was like, oh yeah, it's just a Pirate Master. But in the second phase, all my training paid off, because in Shantae, there are achievements to beat all of the bosses without getting hit once. And I did get the achievement of not getting hit on the Pirate Master. Like, it took me, oh god, it must have took me like 300-400 attempts. And because, like, if you get hit in the first 5 seconds, then it's, you know, that's 5 second reset, or you could go for a minute. So, it, you know, 200 minutes is like 4 hours. And his final phase gets really hard, because the cannonballs kill you in one hit. You won't see the cannonballs in this phase because you don't have them, but the cannonballs kill you in one hit on the don't get hit achievements. And because I've played the Pirate Master, like, over and over and over, his second phase, over and over and over and over and over and over, just trying to get this achievement, I was just like, man, I'm completely in the zone. I'm not getting hit by the Pirate Master at all. And obviously I get through the Pirate Master without taking any damage. It was pretty damn good. You'll see it coming up now, because his first phase just goes down real easy. Anyway, for a genie kid, you don't do sure pack much of a punch, do you? You're saying I'm weak. In fact, he'd be nothing without my weapons. I think I'll just take them off your hands. I mean, I didn't use my weapons out of all of that first phase, so I don't know what you're on about. And you already have the weapons. Look, the pistol, we haven't seen the pistol. Scimitar already on his belt. Hat, he's already wearing his hat. Boots, he's already wearing the boots. Cannon's already on his shoulder. You're not taking them back, you just used the Yarrow Rune. You just duplicated them to have two, because you're greedy. Anyway,
I'll show you true power. Let's watch the Pirate Master show us true power as he evolves into his second phase. The Pirate Master, fully powered Evil King, Pirate King.
And we're just going to activate a bubble, a super fight ball, and a monster milk to take him down as fast as possible. Don't know why I had a bento box, I was already at full health. But yeah, these cannonballs are an insta-kill, so you've got to be really careful with them. Or they've been an insta-kill for me so much on the Don't Get Hit achievement that I now just see them as an insta-kill. Because even on like the Don't Get Hit achievements, the swords, the pistols he's creating now, and the bones that he makes in the next phase of this battle, those three don't kill me at all. Cannonball always killed me in the Don't Get Hit thing, so now I'm just under this assumption that cannonballs are an insta-kill, so you gotta watch out for that. But anyway, all you gotta do is climb his bones and smack the hell out of him, and he will go down, no problem whatsoever. So sometimes you can get him in one phase if you've been hitting him, you know, like across the course of the battle like I was, but it does take me two phases, although hilariously, when I hit him once he goes down, so he was literally like one hit away from death, and I'm like, oh man, so close yet so far, just one hit away from death. So we will see that in a moment. We just gotta let him do his second phase. Second phase is rather easy because it's so good how the Pirate Master works. Like, sorry about that, Audacity just cut out for some reason. I guess it's because I'd left the computer idle for too long and the screen went black. But yeah, it's so good how the Pirate Master works, but we'll talk about that after the cutscene, because obviously he's not dead. But let's just let him explode for a second. Arr! Certainly likes laughing a lot.
Genie girl! Aye, you've got a whole lot of dark magic in that lamp of yours. Hand it over, or I'll crush this has-been beneath me heel.
I mean, you haven't got heels, you're just a flying body right now.
What's it gonna be? The dark magic or her life?
Risky. If I hand over the dark magic, you've promised not to hurt her.
I swear it on me grave.
He's a filthy liar. Don't give it to him. Well, I mean, I want that kiss, Risky. Here, just take it. Just let Risky go.
Yes, we've done a good thing. Risky will be happy with us. We've done a good thing. We saved her life. Now they will kiss after all this is over and done with.
I will impress you, Risky. I will get that kiss.
I knew you'd see things my way.
But it's not dark magic anymore.
What is this nonsense? Bah! Light magic! I've no use for this filth.
Risky was right. The dark magic was really my magic all along.
You can't trust that coward. She just fled to save her own skin.
Risky's no coward. She meant for me to use it. And now, the moment of truth. We press X. And we're gonna get all of our magic back. Oh, hold on. There we go. Again, do you notice how the silence? There's no music as it's a transition point. It's building up to the next part of the fight, the witness. I knew Risky was telling the truth.
Ah, curse that Risky Boots. I will wipe you and every last genie from existence.
And then the music kicks in. You see, witness, silence is used as a transition point. Well, let's power ourselves up and whack him just a little bit. And as you can see, now there's four balls and they get pretty violent. But yeah, this is what I was going to say before we did that cutscene. The Pirate Master is a fantastic way to show you how game mechanics and bosses should work. Like, we have the first phase where he just had like the regular cannonballs, regular pistols and stuff. And then in the second phase, it's a little bit harder, but you already know some of the mechanics. Like, obviously, we have the cannonballs that bounce slightly differently, and there's four instead of three. The scimitars that move back and forth, and then you've got to move into the gap at the last second. And the pistols which home in on you, which is kind of balls, because I can never avoid that. God knows how I did it on the Don't Get Hit thing.
But yeah, and also, we're doing 999 damage with every blast of our hair. This guy's going down. He ain't gonna be doing anything. Let me just waggle the mouse to make sure that we don't lose Audacity again, just to make sure that the computer doesn't think it's idle. So this is like fantastic game design. The boss is designed in such a way that it taught you the mechanics in the first round, and then you have to actually put those mechanics with a little bit of extra challenge into practice in the real second round. I mean, I guess this is like the third round with him, because we beat his small form, then we beat his big form, and you know, now we're beating his big form a second time. And look, you can see his belt there. You don't even have any heals, and again, he was only one hit away from death. But anyway, Lucario, I'm warning you, Photon, don't touch them Lucario girls. I know what you like, Lucario. Ready to fire, Captain. Pull for my order. And this phase is easy as long as you keep whipping. Like, if you just mash the shit out of the whip button, you get stunlocked. Like, look, he cannot move whatsoever. He's just stunlocked forever. And obviously, we're going to put cannonballs through this guy's face. We're going to blow that. We're going to blow Skeletor's drunken brother sky high. And I think I don't know how he broke out of that, I'll be honest, because 90% of the time he's just completely stunlocked, as you can see, like, he can't move, so I'm not sure what caused the stunlock there, and he is dead, like, or at least his big power is removed. We have sucked all of the dark magic out and converted it to light magic one more time, so now he's just a tiny little man again. And once again, silence is a transition point. You're finished, Pirate Master.
You cannot destroy me.
I mean, that looks pretty destroyed. You just blew up. Blew himself up. That's the last of him. There's just one thing left to do. Like what?
Kiss. The last thing left to do is kiss. Kiss her. Kiss her.
She earned it, Risky. I earned it, Risky. Kiss me. Kiss me. I earned it, Risky. The pirate weapons. It's time I took them back. Ah! Such cock tease.
But Risky, what about the curse?
There's nothing to fear. The curse has been broken. I'm in charge of my own destiny now. I won't let the darkness rule over me any longer. Take a shot.
So, you're going to become a good guy?
I didn't say that. Listen carefully, Runt. You walked the walk, and you talked the talk. Heh, you even dressed the part. But in the end, you're no seafaring cutthroat. Far from it. You can't pretend to be something you're not, and neither can I. So long.
Risky, I...
Run after her, Shantae. Kiss her. I know you're regretting it. Look, that is the face of regret. That is the face of a girl that regrets missing that Risky kiss. Relieve your sexual tension. Don't go. See, she's saying don't go. Run to her, Shantae. Run to her. Kiss her. It's going to be all right. Fuck you, Uncle. No, it's not. I didn't get the kiss off Risky Boots. It's not all right, Uncle. She'll have to discover her own path. Oh, Uncle. Uncle, you don't know what's going on here. Excuse me, Uncle. You're a man. You're not a woman. You do not understand the sexual tensions. You do not understand my feelings towards Risky. Shantae needs to run and kiss her. I mean, did you not see that face of regret? And you can show up, Bolo. You joined the fucking Techno Baron! You're just a betrayer! I don't even want to speak to you! Sky maybe, but not you! Anyway, is Risky Boots still here? No, she's gone. She's gone. Soul crushing. I still haven't washed my head since that time she punched me. You fucking leave her alone, Bolo. She is mine. I am the one that will kiss Risky. Not you. I don't care if you have a crush on him. Risky's mine, Bolo. You know, in the words of Metaton from that one thread simulator, you wanna fucking go? We'll go, Bolo. Don't you ever think about Risky that way again. Risky is for Shantae and Shantae only. And those Lucario girls aren't for you either, Photon. I know that she's on screen, and I know that she's looking the way you want her to look, but don't touch them, Photon. Anyway, we've just got one piece of unfinished business, and that's with the Macho Man Randy Savage Ammo Baron.
A Motown could really use a guardian genie like you.
I could certainly vouch for her character if it would make her happy.
No thanks. I've got something else in mind. I'm only a half genie, and I've never granted someone's wish. But I think I'm ready to give it a try. This one's for you, Mayor.
Ooh.
No! Weeks of hard labor and materials gone to waste.
The people of Scuttletown are through with you, Ammo Baron. Now take a hike, you scum-sucking scallywag, or I'll clean your gills from ear to ear.
She's bewitched and speaking in blabber tongue. Let's clear out of here, boys. Move it.
I mean, they said it men. Well, Macho Man Randy Savage always says boys.
Get ready, boys. Slip into some Slim Jims.
I can't believe it. My beautiful town has been restored to needs work condition. You'll always have a place here as our guardian. Promise me you'll never ever leave.
Aw, Mare. You're a clumsy idiot that sold the town, but we forgive you. And here's the zombies to come greet us. Abner, Poe and Rytops.
Gonna hand it to you. You saw something in that pirate girl that the rest of us missed. Just like you did with little sis here.
Huh. I just woke from the most wondrous dream.
What did you dream about?
I was a hero just like you. I saved everyone who was lost and helped them find their way home. I'll tell you about it tonight. What's tonight? Sleepover at your house.
Now that we've moved back to the mainland, I'm going to track down our caravan. Maybe we should open up our own coffee wagon.
Yes, do that. But in the meantime, Rytops. Now, fuck Rytops. We don't care about Rytops. Your brother, Poe, Poe's got it going. Make a coffee shop. Me and Shino will vat if it tastes good. Like, I'll bring Shino in, and Shino can taste your coffee. If Shino approves your coffee, then you know it's good. Because Shino, he is addicted to coffee. Like, every stream,
Aggie, I need to go get some coffee. Shino needs some coffee. I love coffee, Aggie.
So, like, we bring Shino in. If Shino's like,
oh my god, Poe, your coffee is so good, Poe. Make your coffee caravan.
If Shino likes your coffee, then you can slap that on the side of your wagon and be like, Poe's coffee wagon, approved by Shino. Like, those three words, approved by Shino, are just like five Rosé Michelin star, five star food quality seal of approval thing. If you get Shino's approval on coffee, then you've got like the 5-star food rating for coffee. Rytops appears to have had a head start thanks to you.
Shush, Poe, that's a spoiler for the next game. I know we might have seen her in the Village of Lost Souls, but that's a spoiler for the next game. And I'm not the coffee lady, but Shino is certainly the coffee pony.
I should have got Shino to do this line now. Just be like, Shino, there's someone talking about coffee. Give them your thoughts on coffee. And I'd be like,
I want to see them make coffee in the new game.
Maybe. Maybe if they actually do make that coffee shop in Half Genie Hero, I'll bring Shino in. I'll be like, alright, Shino, in this episode, we're going to a coffee shop. This is your section, my friend. This is your section. Anyway, let's wrap it all up with the
potential spoilers from Uncle.
So, I think Sky should be going, yep, everything's back to normal.
The magic was the key to awakening that curse and bringing him back.
It appears that it was also his undoing.
Indeed it was.
Yeah, well, Risky had him figured out from the start. Always one step ahead.
I think she was just lucky. No one is that manipulative.
Or are they?
Anyway, I've got to get back to work.
Sure did, half genie once again.
I should pay attention to the actual chat now. Or the text on screen.
And I'm bursting with brand new ideas for my next dance moves.
And I'm from the future, Shantae. Shantae, I'm from the future. And I've seen that your future adventure is gonna be bloody fantastic. I want half genie arrow now. I want it now. It's gonna be good. But I've seen your brand new dance moves. I've seen you turn into a crab. I've seen it all, Shantae. I've seen you wiggling your little booty as you slide down that slide. I mean, you can just watch my Half Genie Hero demo if you need to know what I'm on about, but... Oh, I can't wait! I can't wait, Shantae! I'm a time traveler and I've come back from the future. It's all good. But why was Uncle conducting experiments? Well, he was conducting experiments on magic, and I thought that perhaps the polarity of the magic could be reversed. I figured there might be some way to restore your powers. But it looks like you proved that theory on your own.
Thank you for everything, Uncle. I'm sorry for running off with Risky and not telling you.
You're a handful, young woman. But you gave Risky Boots a chance that most folks never would. You may never become a full genie like your mother.
Pause. I guess I was...
But you're becoming more like her in far more important ways. She'll see it for herself one day when you finally meet her.
Shh! Uncle, shh!
You can't shush, Uncle! Spoilers!
Someday.
And that's the... And we get the secret 100% ending. This is what you get if you've got everything and killed the Pirate Master's true form. I thought I'd find you here, and the Tinkerbats are back to normal. Looks like your Tinkerbats are back to normal. They've got a lot of work to do. The Tinker Tub will need serious upgrades before I launch my next attack.
That's quite... Yeah, it's only a few months away, Risky. You better hurry, it's only a few months away!
So exciting!
Still, trying to convince me to become a good guy.
I was just hoping to ask you something. How did you know the dark magic would change?
Oh, that. I didn't know. It was just a hunch. I figured if I gave you the lamp, you'd put it to good use. And when I heard about the dreams, I figured the magic must be yours.
But you knew that I wouldn't destroy it. Somehow, you knew that it would change.
How could it not? With you sailing all over the seven seas, doing good deeds for every hard luck case? I make it a point to know my enemies. I knew the Pirate Master would make a grab for the dark magic, and I knew you'd do the opposite of common sense and hand it over.
Well, yeah, to save you.
Exactly. Alright, men, snap to it. We're shipping out. That doomsday device won't build itself. Wash your back, run.
You too.
Oh, and one more thing. You want to kiss me?
Huh?
You want to kiss me, don't you? I can see it in those yellow eyes of yours. I don't know why your sprite has yellow eyes when you clearly don't. You have red eyes, and you've had red eyes on every single one of your pictures like that one there. Your mother, you're just like her, only shorter and more annoying.
Risky. Smooth sailing.
I'm going to get that kiss off you in Half Genie Hero, Risky. I promise you that. Then that is the true ending. That is the credits. Oh my word! This is going to be a long video, but what do you expect for the final world and the final boss? Oh my god, that man's come back from the dead!
I thought we killed him.
I watched him turn to stone
and crumble to dust. It's magic. It's magic.
And there's Nigel Thornberry hiding in the bushes.
And you know what? In the words of Nigel Thornberry, this game was simply smashing.
Oh, it was. I love this series so much. I love it. It was such a fun playthrough. I had so much fun playing through the game. And I just can't wait for Half Genie Hero. Like, Half Genie. Oh, I'm excited. I mean, especially because I got my hands on the demo. Thank you very much for the demo, Way Forward. I appreciate that demo very much. It was such a great demo. And now, like, I need it now! I need it now! I need it! I need Half Genie! I want my Half Genie Hero now! But now. No, this was, we'll ignore Half Genie Hero for now, but this was an absolutely fantastic playthrough. It's just such a enjoyable series. Like, there's nothing that really frustrates me. Like, all of it, bar the speedrun achievement, which is just kind of shit, and the second speedrun achievement, which is like, get 100% in 3 hours. Bar the speedrun achievement, there's just like, nothing wrong with this game. Like, it's fast-paced, it's colourful, the music's lively, it's fun. Shantae is just always, like, a fun, colourful series. And, like, I love that about Way Forward. Like, they take Iwata, rest in peace. They take his thing of a game should be fun over everything else, quite literally. Like, you do the fun first, and then you add the challenge second. And you keep adding challenge, yes, but you've still got to make sure that it's fun above everything else, and Way Forward always does that. It's so good. It's just, yes, so I can't wait to play Half Genie Hero, which is coming out in a few months. But for now, that is the end, and I'm just going to say now, while we wrap up here, I did record an extra couple of minutes on the end, like an extra 4 minutes or 3 minutes to wrap up here, because we are at the end of this next indie let's play. This indie let's play has come to the end. I have seen Captain Dirklish, and I've been talking to Captain Dirklish, who is doing my Undertale end slate for the Neutral Undertale run, and he's currently sketching it right now. So it's not quite ready yet. He might actually be inking it tonight, not like colouring it, just inking all the lines, and then he'll put the solid colours in tomorrow or something. But he is currently sketching it right now, so we don't have the Undertale end slate ready just yet. So for the next indie game, I'm going to be doing Spooky's House of Jump Scares. I'm going to actually make the Spooky's House of Jump Scares the end slate for this particular title, so that you can see what the end slate looks like, just to show it off. And that's only like maybe going to be 5 episodes long, so it's quite a short game, but it's still a really fun, enjoyable game. Like, this one lasted about 17 episodes, so I imagine that one will last like 8, maybe 9 at most. So we're going to do Spooky's House of Jump Scares next, you know, just a nice short let's play while the Undertale end slate gets finished, and then we'll move on to Undertale. So thank you all for watching this episode. It was such a fun playthrough, and I am slowly but surely climbing my way to 500 subscribers. We're nearly at the next milestone, and I appreciate it so much, like the fact that now 500 people are, or nearly 500 people are getting there. Last I checked, I had 158, so we're 42 away from the next milestone, which that is such an amazing thing to be so close to the next milestone. Like, I'm in arm's reach of touching it now, but that'll come later when we've got like 490 and we're a lot closer. But we are on our last minute here, so I'm going to wrap up this fantastic let's play that I really had fun with it. But again, thank you all for watching this let's play. If you enjoyed this episode and the Shantae series as a whole, then please, please do hit that like button. It really shows your support. If you don't want to miss out on Spooky's House of Jump Scares or any of the other indie games that will be coming in the future, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. And as always, if you want to go
The extra mile, there is always a link to my Patreon below, although all videos will always be free for viewing. It's just if you want to go that extra mile and show your support a little bit further, but of course you don't have to. But with that being said, thank you all for watching, and I will see all of you in the next series, which is Spooky's House of Jump Scares.